Good morning, I'm Tyne Morgan, coming to you from our Farm Journal Kansas City studios. Clinton is on assignment this week. Well, President Biden and Chinese President Xi Jinping held a virtual summit last night. The White House saying ahead of time that no major announcement was expected. The talks coming as the clock ticks down on the Phase 1 trade agreement between the two countries. The deal officially started in January of last year and it ends December 31st of this year. So how has China done under that agreement? We'll take a look at this graphic from the Peterson Institute for International Economics. It shows that as of September, China's purchases of all covered products reached 62% of Chinese imports or 60% of U.S. export targets. For agriculture specifically, it has reached 76% of the target. Ohio State economist Ian Sheldon focuses on policy and trade, and he tells me while China is not buying at the same pace of last year, it's important to note that it's still the top buyer for U.S. agriculture products.
In terms of agricultural exports, it looks like for 2021, we're going to hit about 84% of the commitments that China made to import. So, and a lot of that's going to be dependent as we go out towards, you know, through the end of the marketing year, particularly how much corn and soybeans are exported to China. But if you look at exports to China across commodities, soybeans are not hitting the target that they were expected to hit, but corn is way over target. We're talking about 1,000% higher than where it was expected to be, along with our pork exports have been very strong to China and our wheat exports and our cotton exports.
Economists point out that as China worked to rebuild its hog herd following an outbreak of African swine fever, the appetite for feed grew. That was a major factor in the U.S. exporting a record amount of ag products last year.